there are 21 active cases of coronavirus in Victoria. That's the one that we announced last night, the first gentleman from Noble Park, and two cases that are in hotel quarantine. A total of 13,675 test results were received today, and we're very grateful to all of those people. I'll come back to testing and how important that is in just a moment. After last night's positive case, the one that we briefed you on last evening, there's been a very big team of people working throughout the night, and they'll continue working until we have absolute control of this. There are many, many hundreds of people who've been contacted. The number of exposure sites, as we predicted last night, has grown. It's very important that people get the best information and then make the decision to go and get tested. That's the most important thing, and that's what I'm asking all Victorians to do that have been anywhere near these exposure sites, or any Victorian who's got any symptoms, however mild, getting tested and not delaying, not waiting an hour, not waiting till tomorrow, but getting tested today is critically important. And to that end, we're so pleased to see a very strong response, particularly out in the southeast. I'll ask Jerome to speak in a moment to additional testing sites that we're standing up, so strong is the demand. There will be delays, and it can be no other way in many ways. We can't have people just stampeding through these places. It's got to be done carefully, slowly, meticulously. I don't want a testing site to become a super spreading site, so it has to be done very carefully. We have stood up additional test sites, and we have further announcements to make, and Jerome will deal with those in just a moment. I can, in good news though, indicate that overnight testing of the 26-year-old Noble Park man's close family contacts, the people he lives with and family members he'd spent time with, they have come back, those two tests have come back negative. So that is very positive news. Early stages, but that is very positive news. He has 20 primary close contacts we've been able to contact and speak with and give advice and direction to 19 of those 20. So that's a very quick response, and we will find that 20th person throughout the day and put a public health response around that person. What this will mean, though, is that many hundreds of people will have to isolate at home, and this is, again, that proven method of the case, the primary close contacts and secondary close contacts, those three rings, if you like. That's the most important part. In terms of, yes, inconveniencing and locking down many hundreds, perhaps even thousands of people, but not having to put in place rules that affect millions more. The early signs are many, many people have come out to get tested, and I'm very grateful, deeply grateful to every single one of those people. That's how we will bring control to this. That's how we will suppress this. That's how we will remain safe and remain open. So I'm very grateful. And yes, there will be delays. There is no other way around it. It's got to be done meticulously. It's got to be done very carefully. Those two negative results overnight are very pleasing. The exposure sites are now up to 14, as I indicated a moment ago. Just finally from me, before I ask Jerome just to speak to some additional testing sites and some of the other work we're doing to get more and more people through the testing locations, I did mention last night that we were taking some additional wastewater samples. So that's happened overnight, and there'll be some additional analysis, so more than we would normally do. And that's appropriate, I think. But I can also confirm that the last regular wastewater collection and sample results from that regular and ongoing program of testing was in fact on Tuesday, and it was negative. So these are all good, positive early signs. We have got to this in good time. There's an army of people working as hard as they can to bring control to this. The community response has been amazing to this point. And we've seen those negative test results, whether it be in wastewater or the very close family contacts of this particular gentleman. That's all positive news. Sorry, I should just add before I ask Jerome to speak to test sites. We have reviewed, CQV have reviewed literally days worth of CCTV footage. And it's fair to say that this person has been a model employee and has done everything that he should do, whether it's doffing and donning a PPE, all the other protocols, all the other rules that are followed. And of course, he's also provided us with very detailed accounts of where he's been, as well as any other information that we've needed. So we're very grateful to him. And further to some questions last night, we can find no problem, no breach of protocol, anything of that nature in terms of his employment. This speaks to the wildly infectious nature of this virus. It speaks to the fact that these mutant strains of this virus are an even greater challenge than even all the things that we faced during 2020. This model of hotel quarantine is, every other state and territory has agreed to copy this model. It is best practice, but still, as I've said many times, it's not about if there will be transmission, it's about when. And that's only made more acute because we keep seeing these hyper-infectious variant strains coming forward. There's a big challenge here, but I think we're equal to it, and I'm deeply grateful to every Victorian who is playing their part in a general sense and those who've responded to our call to test. Those queues are long, but please get your test done. It's the most important thing you can do. And Jerome's about to talk about how we'll make those queues a bit shorter by some additional sites that we're opening up.
Thank you, Premier. Good morning. So it's been a busy but productive night, and we will continue to work at pace over the next few days to run this outbreak to ground in the way that we have dealt with our previous outbreaks here in Victoria. In terms of contact tracing, as the Premier said, there are now 20 family close contacts who are isolating, and we are putting our support around them, and pleasing to see some of the negative early results we've seen on two of those tests. More tests, of course, will be coming in over the next day or so in that area. We also are dealing with around 600 at this moment work close contacts. These are people that this individual has worked with over the two-week period in the hotel quarantine program at the Grand Hyatt. All those 600 people have been instructed to isolate and to go and get tested, and all of them will be contacted today individually to discuss their movements and their exposure. We are, of course, reviewing with our colleagues in CQV any evidence we have of movements within the hotel, and we will do our best to obviously reduce that number of people and to identify any of those who may indeed be close contacts. But we are taking a very risk-averse approach at this point, and have asked all those 600 people to stand down, to isolate, and to ensure they get tested, and we will support them to do just that. We are also working with colleagues in Tennis Australia, around 520 players and staff who completed their quarantine at the Grand Hyatt. They have all been asked to and instructed to test and isolate today. There will be dedicated test facilities for them to ensure we get their testing results done and that we can then rule them out from the inquiry. They are casual contacts. We are not as concerned about them. But again, out of an abundance of caution, we want to ensure we leave no stone unturned in how we follow up and deal with anybody who may have had contact with this individual. With regards to the exposure sites, we now have 14 exposure sites. That's up from 8 when we last spoke to you last night. And again, we will continue our conversations and discussions today, not only with the individual, but any other positive cases that we may identify over the coming hours. So please keep an eye on that on those exposure sites. Anybody who has been at those exposure sites, and we have very precise time windows for those exposure sites, should immediately isolate, should get tested, and remain isolated for 14 days. We will be in touch with you if you come forward. We are, of course, working with those venues to follow up their contact tracing systems. And again, we'll be reaching out that way. But if you have been at those locations, and there are some quite big locations there, in those time windows, we need you to isolate and to go and get tested and to remain isolated for 14 days or until you hear otherwise from us. With regards to testing, first I'd like to thank all those Victorians right now who've either got tested already this morning or have been waiting to get tested in the last few hours. We had 13 sites open, some before 8 o'clock, most of them between 8 and 8:30. We have additional lanes and capacity on all of those sites, and some of them are very busy. We are moving some people between sites. I have some sites that have waiting times of around an hour and a half. I have one site, the Springers Leisure Centre, that 10 minutes ago, was running at around 4 hours, and we are looking to move some of the people onto other nearby sites. That work will continue throughout the day. Our website has live information about the length of queues. We'd ask you to check before you go to the site that you want to go to make sure that the queues there are not excessively long, and if there is a site that may be a little further away but that may have shorter queue times, then that would be my advice to go and pursue that. We are setting up an additional 4 or 5 sites today. There will be a site opening up at Noble Park during the course of this morning. We're working on sites at Monash Health in Clayton, at Brighton and in CBD, and we're exploring one or two other sites in Bayside. That work will continue throughout the day, and we will advise as and when those sites go live. This is all about creating the capacity, not only for the people who are in that close contact field, but for any Victorian who at this point feels that any concerns that they may have been in contact with this individual or that anybody who is displaying symptoms. As the Premier has said, we know this virus is wildly infectious. We know it is still now an issue for us to deal with yet again. We will, as a Victorian community, deal with this in the same way as we always do, which is that we will act swiftly and promptly. I apologise for any delays that you're going to experience this morning if you're standing in those lines, but it is an important thing to complete today, and we will ensure that the testing capacity is there today, tomorrow, over the weekend, and as long as is necessary to run this particular outbreak to ground. And finally, with regard to wastewater testing, we are now conducting daily wastewater testing, particularly in the southeast water catchment. We, of course, do at least bi-weekly across the rest of the state. At the moment, those results are negative as of Tuesday, but we will continue to watch those results very closely and follow up any traces that we do find. And with that, I'll hand back to the Premier. Thank you.
We're good. Happy to take any questions you have.
Is there any theory yet on how this man caught the virus?
Oh, look, we will have a series of meetings today. Our public health team will sit down and work through all the different possibilities. You know, one of the things we can't rule out is that there's aerosol transmission, so airborne transmission of this. That is very challenging, very, very challenging. And I know AHPBC has been dealing with some of these issues, and no doubt this will be a feature of the report that I'll give to National Cabinet tomorrow. All of us work together and learn from each other, and there'll be different experiences in different states. And again, with a virus, it's not static, like it's changing. And so whether it's South Africa, Japan, the UK strain, whatever's next to come and, you know, pose a challenge to us, we all have to work together. So we don't have a definitive answer on that. It's just that step-by-step painstaking detective work. Looking at all the CCTV footage was really important. But the other thing too, James, is the more test results we get back and the more people we can rule out, that'll help us with that evolving theory also. But there's no obvious breach. There's no problem we can say, right, that's probably where it happened. So we will have to wait until we get more of that contact tracing done, more of the test results, and then we'll be able to narrow the field down, if you like.
Can you rule out that it's caught in the community and it's just a coincidence that he works in hydrophoric?
Well, I suppose you can't definitively rule that out until you get genomic sequencing, which we will get probably tomorrow. But the working theory and the assumption, and I think it's a well-founded one, is that he's got it in hotel quarantine, despite not having done anything to breach infection control protocols, again, speaking to the hyper-infectivity of this UK strain.
Seeing as this has happened, would you be reviewing the hotel quarantine program again?
It's reviewed every single day, so there's always learnings, there's always things that need to be changed. There's nothing obvious here. That's the issue and that's the challenge. Minister Neville yesterday made some announcements with CQV in relation to residents getting it from each other, separate program, separate hotel, different time frame. But that, I think, gives you a sense that every day we're looking to learn. This is not a theory. This is not an academic exercise. It's happening in real time, and it does present you with twists and turns and new pieces of information. You know, this is go back a month, go back 2 months ago. UK strain is not something that we were dealing with. South African strain, some of the other stuff that we have to deal with. It's a very, very dynamic environment. No, there's a well-established process, and as for other states and the decisions they make, I'll leave that to them. My focus is on making sure that we bring control to this. At the moment, we have one case. We are taking an abundance of caution approach because you don't get a second chance. And the most important thing here is, I think in terms of new information today, I'm very pleased that family members, so people that he lives with, people that he spent time with, are not positive at this stage. That is good news. But it is only early.
Yeah, so I don't know exactly. The case interview went for a number of hours last night, and we were able to get very, very detailed information. I think he went to his phone and was able to work out exactly where he was. He was symptomatic. We understand from the test that it returned a what's called a low cycle threshold, which means a relatively high viral load, which is why we're taking sort of a very cautious approach to those close contact, to those public exposure sites, and asking people to come forward and be tested if they've been in any of those sites at that time. Look, I think it's probably not rocket science to say that he's probably caught it from one of the cases. We are aware that there were six cases at that hotel. Obviously, they were moved out to hard quarantine, to the health hotels, when they were diagnosed. But obviously, there is that process where they are moved. But we don't know of any breaches at that time. So, and obviously, the genomics results are still pending.
Are you even aware of him spending any time in spaces or contact with objects that those people might have had contact with?
So we are aware he's a what's called a resident support officer. So he's he works on the floor, and we are aware that he was on a floor where there were cases.
That is normally the press conference in Melbourne. So what we know right now in Victoria is that one hotel quarantine worker has tested positive to COVID-19. He has two family members so far. They have tested negative, and he has 20 primary contacts who will also be tested in the coming hours. There are two new cases in hotel quarantine. Where this man worked is one of the quarantine hotels linked to the Australian Open. There are 600 people in that hotel who will be tested and monitored. There are 520 people linked to the tennis who have left and completed their hotel quarantine who will now be tested as well. The question that hasn't been answered and hasn't been asked yet at that press conference is what happens to the Australian Open now? And the opposition in Victoria is putting a lot of pressure. They want a call made in the next 48 hours on the future. If you can remember the scenes back to the Grand Prix last year in Melbourne where the crowds were lining up waiting to go in and the last minute was called off. They do not want a repeat of that situation.
Well, crowds is probably the first thing they'll look at there, and whether or not that's a feasible option for them. And in the meantime, the list of exposure sites has increased to 14 from 8. So the most up-to-date list can be found on the DHHS website for you.